Good afternoon, everyone. In the afternoon session, I want to inform you about the scope of the class project. About the scope of the class project is quite similar for the previous semester because of the previous semester, every group is not finished, and today we will for the scope of the class project we will use the same topic from the previous semester. About the scope of the class project, the topic of the class project is the automatic watering system for the smart farm. The idea is from the farmer, he want to spray the water, and they want to feed the fertilizer to the plants by the mobile application. The farmer want to grow the vegetable. This one is the like up eat the salad, maybe or green oak salad or they have many salad type. Want to use the vertical farm. About the vertical farm, this one is prepared for grow the salad. In the vertical farm, it consists of the six salad to grow the salad. About of each salad is the controlled by the if you want to feed the water to each salad, is controlled by the soil. The water is controlled by the six solenoid valve. Actually, about the six solenoid valve, it can be we can control six solenoid valve by using one output. if we send the output equal to one, or of six solenoid valve, it will on at the same time, and water it will out and spray to the for the each salad. And if when the water spray to the soil, and if the farmer want to measure the soil moisture, they on each slot it will install the soil moisture sensor. This one is the sensor to measure the soil moisture. This sensor it will have the output starting from 0 until 100. And okay, about the salad, if you spray only water, is you cannot make it grow. If you want to make it grow, you should be feed the fertilizer A and fertilizer B when you spray the water. We cannot feed the fertilizer to the salad without the water, because the fertilizer is small, the pressure is very small. Then if you want to feed, if the farmer want to feed the fertilizer and A or B, they will feed when the solenoid valve is on, like that. Fertilizer B, this one is like a fertilizer, it will have the nitrogen and phosphorus and potassium, different with the fertilizer B. This one is like a formulation for the fertilizer, formulation for the nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium. That will feed to the salad. And this one is the plant. We can summarize the input and output. It consists of only four. It's consists of three output and one input. The first input is the solenoid valve. You will see this one is the solenoid valve. As I told you, if you want to make all of six solenoid valve on, it need only one output. This one is the output to make solenoid valve on. It has only two level or off or on like that. And the second output is the fertilizer A. Fertilizer A, this one is the when you want to feed fertilizer A to the system. This one is the small pump, is the plasmatic pump. If you want to feed fertilizer A to the vertical farm, you can make, if you on it, the plasmatic pump, it will feed the fertilizer A into the vertical farm. But if you want to feed the fertilizer A, that I told you, so it should be on also. And if you want to feed fertilizer A or B, you can control the output by time. The time is will starting from 0 until 10 seconds. Assume 1 second it equal to 10 cc. But you don't worry about the cc, you just control depend on time. Okay, the farmer, they will specify the time to feed fertilizer A or B to the plant. And the last one is the soil moisture. Soil moisture is the sensor. This one will feed back to your controller. When you spray the water into your plant, and how to measure the soil moisture level, you can measure by soil moisture. Actually, we have for six lot, but you can, I think, all of slot it has same value. Then you can use only one sensor to measure. The soil moisture, it will starting from 0 until 99%. 0, it mean dry. Soil, it will dry condition, and 99 is will like a wet condition. This one is has the 100 level, starting from 0 until 99%. The farmer, they will set it. If the farmer want to spray the water to the soil, they will set this parameter by the mobile phone. Assume they set 80%. That mean they want to spray the water to the soil. The wet condition is around 80% like that. But this one is the list of output and input, and we don't have the actual output and actual input. We can simulate it by LED on the microcontroller board. If you want to simulate the signal output for the soil wall and for the fertilizer A and fertilizer B, you can simulate it by LED status. Because of our on the STM32 board, you see that they prepare four LED on board. We can apply three LED for this class project. On the diagram that I show, I did not specify the GPIO pin for you. You can specify the IO pin that you want to use by yourself. But the GPIO pin that connect to the LED is the pin is the PD12 until pin PD15. You can select any pin from that list for the solenoid valve, for the fertilizer A and fertilizer B pump, this one. And about we don't have the real moisture sensor. We can use the, you see that the soil moisture, it can be adjusted starting from 0 until 99%. You can adjust it by use the wearable sensor, a wearable resistor, and you connect wearable resistor to the analog input. You choose the analog input by yourself, and you convert the digital value back to the soil moisture level starting from 0 until 99% by equation. You can convert from 0 until 4095 to the 0 to 99%. That means you can use the wearable resistor simulate for the soil moisture like that. And you see from the scope of the farmer, they need the programmer develop the application by on the mobile phone, because I think every farmer in Thai or many country everyone have the mobile phone, and when you want to use the mobile phone, actually I think two OS for mobile phone that popular in today is the Android and iOS. Then I don't know about the farmer, which farmer who use the Android, and I think some farmer they familiar with the iOS. Then if you want to develop the application on mobile phone, you should be thinking about the application that you want to develop. It should be support for Android and iOS. Then I choose the Blink application. Because of the Blink application, this application they support on both iOS, Android and iOS. That's why I select the Blink application for this class project. That is the scope. We should be use Blink application in the class project. And from the class project, okay, we will use the Blink application that support for Android and iOS. And for the STM32 board, they don't in this board they don't support the Wi-Fi signal. They don't connect to the internet. Actually, they can connect to the internet by using the LAN module. By using LAN module, we can connect the internet by using STM32 board. But I did not prepare that board for everyone. Because of that board, that can make the STM32 board connect to the internet. I think it's not good solution if you want to apply this board connect to the internet, because now you will find that for nowadays it's very easy to connect to the internet by using the Wi-Fi module. But when you want to use the STM32F4 connect to the Wi-Fi, unfortunately, this board cannot connect direct to the Wi-Fi also. Then I give another microcontroller board for you in the box set. You see, we prepare ESP32 board. This one is the microcontroller also. But this board, they don't have the LED. They don't prepare the LED on board. But on this board, you can apply ESP32 board, connect to the Wi-Fi in your home or your dorm. But the limitation of the ESP, if you want to apply the ESP connect to the Wi-Fi, they support Wi-Fi signal only 2.4 gigahertz. But I think all of your home and all of your dorm, when they send the Wi-Fi signal into your room, I think they send 2 signal, 5 gigahertz and 2.4 gigahertz, I think. And I think you can use ESP32 to connect to the 2.4. And when you want to control the LED on STM board, we need to use the UART module, send and receive between 2 microcontrollers. This one is the diagram that I prepare. You can use UART on STM32F4. I think we already learned this module for the previous week, and you can apply the theory from that one to the class project also. And I think but you did not learn about the ESP32. Okay, I will explain you after we finish to explain you about the scope for the class project. We will start to learn the basic of the ESP32, and we will try to send and receive between 2 board. I prepare the code in the lecture under the topic week number 5, STM32F4, ESP and doubling. We will learn from that lecture. And if the farmer want to see the status or the status from the output of status from the sensor, we should be prepared the LCD display to show the information that to show the information to the farmer also, because of sometimes the farmer they did not bring mobile phone. They can see the status from the LCD also. Okay. And anyone want to ask something about the introduction, why we use the Blink, why we use the ESP, and why we use the STM32F4, and why we use the LCD? We will apply our microcontroller to control the vertical fan system, and this one is the output. Okay. Okay, no questions. Okay. Next. Then from the requirement from the farmer, they send the requirement to us, and they need the developer to develop the application on the mobile phone. They need a main five screen like this. The first screen is the menu screen. Main screen tab. About the, I will call main screen. Okay, on the main screen, the farmer, if they want to grow the maybe green oak salad or some salad, some vegetable, they need the developer develop the option. Let them set the date, because some salad they want to from the requirement, this one is show the maximum date. The farmer can set a total date for grow the salad starting from 1 until 38 day. This one is the total date to set, and this one we can from the farmer, from the requirement from the farmer, they need the option to set the start date because of the lifetime of salad is around maybe not over 40 days, not over 40 days, 40 or 45 days, I think. They can set the start date by this option. They can, okay, this one is, we can specify the, we can, we prepare this one, let the farmer select, choose the start date. This one is the maximum, the total date that they want to grow the salad. And for the first screen, this button is for the sharing the controller to on or off. If this button, if we press this button, the automatic status, it will change to on. If button, this one is the release, automatic, it will change to off. If automatic change to off, that is the in the manual mode. We prepare mode for the farmer, two mode. Automatic on is mean automatic mode. If automatic mode equal to off is the manual mode, just only automatic or manual like that. This one is the mode. Okay, this one is the detail for the first screen. Okay, the next one is the config screen. From requirement, requirement from the user, they need the programmer develop the screen to config the parameter on each day. That means this one is like a drop down. This one it will show the config day starting from 1 until 38 day. And on this screen, when we select day 1, assume we select day 1, we should be set the time in hour and minute to this time it will the meaning of the time that we set on the day 1 is the time to open the solenoid valve to spray the water to the plant. Assume you set the time equal to 8 a.m. 8 hour and 0 minutes. Assume we set in format of the 24 hour. Assume we set this one is equal to 8 and minute equal to 0. That means on the day 1, farmer want to set the time. That time it will, the meaning of the time is will open the solenoid valve to spray the water to the plant. When we set the time, when we set the time on the day 1, and the farmer should be set the soil moisture also. This one is the soil moisture. Assume they set soil moisture equal to 50%. Okay. For the previous one, assume we set the time equal to this one 8, this one 0, okay, 0, 8, 0, 0, and we set soil moisture equal to 50%. Okay, when the time on day 1 is starting from 0 and the time start counting and reach at 8 a.m. Then on this one, solenoid valve for water is will on. And how to stop the soil moisture? They will stop depend on soil moisture. When soil moisture on, the soil moisture will increase starting from 0, and when the soil moisture reach 50% that we set in the screen, in the option of the soil moisture. This one, the solenoid, while it warm, it will on, and when the soil moisture pass 50%, after that, the solenoid valve, it should be off. Okay, this one is the, if we set only soil moisture and we don't set fertilizer A and fertilizer B, assume we set equal to zero and this one equal to zero, that means they want to spray the water only. No need to feed the fertilizer A and B. Okay, this one, it will until 59. Okay, and then start to the new date. This one is finished for the day one. Okay, and about the day two, assume we set the parameter on the day two, like this. Okay, on the day two. Day two, and we set time on 8 a.m. 08 and 00, and we set soil moisture equal to maybe 60%. And on the day two, farmer want to feed fertilizer A without B. Okay, they set fertilizer A equal 5 seconds, and fertilizer B they set equal to zero, like this. Okay, when the day two is start. When the day two is start, and the time reach at 8 a.m. Okay, maybe on the day two, we can set maybe on the 9 a.m. Assume we set on the 9 a.m. On the 9 a.m. Okay, when the time reach 9 a.m., the water solenoid valve, solenoid for water is will on. It will on, and the soil moisture, you can simulate it by adjust the variable resistor. When the soil moisture is increased until reach to the parameter that you set, that mean when the soil moisture is over than 60%, then solenoid valve it will back to off. That means solenoid valve it will off and no water spray on the farm like that. Like a soil moisture, it will on depend time, but they will off is depend on sensor like that. Okay. At the same time, at 9 a.m., at the same time, not only soil, solenoid valve water, it because of farmer want to feed fertilizer A at that time also. Then fertilizer A at 9 a.m., fertilizer A, it will on also. On around 5 seconds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This one is second, and after 5 seconds, it will off like that. I think fertilizer A, it will off before soil water because of, I think, the response time of the soil moisture it really slow when you spray the water, and they will spend some time to make the soil sensor increase, I think. When you simulate it, about the soil moisture sensor, you can simulate it by adjust the variable resistor, right? And I think it will fertilizer A, you set it by time. I think 5 seconds fertilizer A or B, it will off before soil moisture soil is the about the soil about it should be off after the fertilizer A off. Fertilizer A or B, it will off before soil soil wow, I think. Okay, and after that, the time it will continue until 23:59 minutes, and then they will start new date again to the day 3, like that. This one is the screen to config the parameter on each day. This screen, farmer can config the parameter before run the controller in automatic mode. That means farmer, this screen, you can set the parameter in advance. It, you can prepare the data to grow the, you can prepare data to spray the water, to feed the fertilizer A or B in advance. You can prepare that data before run the controller. And parameter on each day can be set separately. That means day one, we can set time on different on another day. Assume day one we set at 8 a.m. On day two, we can set on 9 a.m. Day three, we can set on 8:30, like that. Day five, we can set on 11 a.m. like that. On 11 like that, not a.m. That mean parameter on each day we can set separately. Okay. And this one is the detail on the config screen tab. And if the farmer after farmer set all the parameter on each day, and if they want to back for check the parameter on any day, they can do it. Like after they set the parameter on starting from day one until day 38 already, and they want to back to check the parameter on day two. When they back on the day two, the parameter that we set it before, it should be shown. Okay. Okay, and the next one, this one is the detail for the monitor screen. Because the farmer want to check the status of the soil moisture, is okay or not, the sensor is still work well, they can check from the monitor screen. On the monitor screen, farmer want to show the current time and current day that that the vertical farm run. And this one show the soil moisture data. This one it will show the real time. When you adjust the variable resistor, this soil moisture it should be vary also. And this one show the time. And the time it should be countdown, starting from that you set back to zero when the soil when the fertilizer A on. It will show the status on off. On or off and show the countdown time. Fertilizer B also. And even show the status for the solenoid valve. Show the on or off like that. This one is the detail. On the monitor screen, we cannot adjust anything, just display only. And I think about the monitor screen in this one, you should be display on the LCD also, LCD display also, because sometimes the farmer did not take the mobile phone. They can show, you should be prepare the LCD display, prepare the screen to display this data. That means this data it can show on mobile phone and it can be show on the LCD. It's like a two-way display. And the next one, it will the manual screen. The detail on the manual screen, about the manual screen, because of when you assume you when you install the when you bring equipment install on the site on the farmer on the field and you want to test the system you want to test the output you want to test the output this screen it will this screen, it will prepare for test, you will see. On the manual screen, on the manual screen, because of we have three output, we will prepare the function to test off each output by this one. If the user, if the farmer want to test the fertilizer A, they just play this button. When they press it, the output for fertilizer A, it will on, and they can make it off by press this button again. Okay, this one is for test fertilizer A and B, and so in a while, when they press it, LED on SCM board, it should be off or on, depend on the status of the button that they test. But we cannot control, we cannot press the button when the when farmer set the automatic mode is on. If the farmer set automatic mode equal to on, that means you run the controller in auto mode. If we are enter in the auto mode, we cannot control direct to the output. We cannot control. It should be controlled by condition that you set in the config screen. Then the farmer should be back to the first main screen tab first and change automatic mode equal to off. That is the, they will bring the mode of the controller in the manual mode. if the automatic mode is equal to off, that means in now the controller change the mode into the manual mode, then we can control direct to the output by button. Okay, this one is for test the output. This screen is very important because of when you finish the installation at the farmer field and you want to test the output first, you can use this screen test the output. Okay. And the last one is the set time screen. Set time screen. About the set time screen, this screen is the because of you see that on the config screen, the farmer can config the parameter in advance. They can prepare the data before run in automatic mode. After the if you want to test the condition on day 1 or day 10 or another day, we have the maximum 38 days. You see that if you want to submit the project, or you want to test the system, you should be if you make the timers run from the beginning, from the 0:00 like that, 0 hour, 0 minute, and 0 second, you if you want to test the parameter on the day one, if you set on the 8 a.m. you should be wait around 8 hour if you want to test the condition on 8 a.m. It's not suitable for the system test because you should be wait around 8 hour to test the system. And if you want to test the condition on day 2, if the timer run from the day 2, you should be wait around 9 hour before condition is view on. It's not good for the developer test. For the set time screen, it will allow you to change the current time and current date by manual. When the developer want to test the system, they will set the parameter on set time and set date. As soon as they want to test the parameter on day 1 at 9 a.m. like this, they just go to the set time screen and they set day on day 2 and set time close to 9 a.m. They set around 58 minutes and 0 second, and they wait around 2 minutes. They wait time run around 2 minutes. You see that we can reduce the time to test the system. We can set the time in the controller in any time or any day. Okay, this one is the detail of the set time screen. When the developer set time or set day, this parameter it will change. The current time and current day it will change also. Okay, this one is the main white screen. I think if you can design more than 6 screen, I think, if you need it. And the last one, about the farmer want to see the status. Because sometimes if they want to see the status of each output like this, they should be let application display all the time. I think it's not suitable. It's not good the solution. Then we will prepare the. I think everyone have the Line account. We can send the status of the solenoid valve or fertilizer A and fertilizer B to the Line notify to the Line application. This one is the example. This one is the notify information. Should be notify the current pen date and operation automatic watering system in manual mode or auto mode. It should be show the on the Line notify. This one is the example to display. It will show on the Line notify in the day one time. And this one is the soil moisture is working, and maybe you can display soil moisture is stopped like that, or moisture. This one is the current moisture. It depend on your. This one is the example. You can notify more than this one. I think you should be notified about the current date like this. Now the system run on day one or day two or day three until day 38 like that. And so in a while on or off now. And fertilizer for that day. Okay, and this one is the scope. And about the Line notify, we can apply the ESP32 to send Line notify, to send notify by Line notify. Okay, about the scope of the of my explanation, anyone want to ask something? And I want to explain you about the class project is consists of only two people, because now we have 10 people in the class. I think we can separate 2 person for group. And when you do it finish, we let the time to present is around 20 minutes per group. And you should be prepared the full report. You should be prepared the document, the word, or report, and presentation. And I think we will have the score for the video presentation also. But I think you can present by the real equipment, and you can present by prepare the video. Because of why we need to present with the video, because when you actually on the submission date, you can if that day and if you want to present with the real one, and on that day is some hardware is not work, you can prepare the video before to make sure that on the present day, on the submit day, everything it will work well. You can prepare the demonstration by the video editing to make sure that you can submit on that day. Because of the, I saw some group on the submission day, they present by the real equipment and the code that they develop, maybe they crash and they don't back up the code from the PC and they cannot submit. I think you should be prepared to wait for presentation by real one or by video. I think to make sure you should be prepared the video for presentation also. And I prefer every group should be prepared the video also to make sure that on the submission day it will work. Okay, this one is the scope for the class project. And from the scope that I explained to you, I want to make you understand about the first one is the STM32F4 and the Blink application we will learn in the next part. And the next one, we will let you try to send and receive the data between ESP32 and STM32F4. We can apply the concept that we learned in the topic of the UART to this one also. Okay, maybe we will try with this one first. Learn about the ESP32 connect to the Blink application. Okay. Anyone want to ask something about the scope? For the theory that we will learn from now. We will let you learn about the theory or concept or programming to, and you can apply this one, apply to the class project. And you will see that every group, now we have 5 groups, they give the concept same, you use the same scope of the project, I think. And I think from the scope that I explained to everyone, you can apply from main idea that I give you to your project. Maybe on the screen, main screen or config screen, you can design your screen by using your idea. It makes the farmer easy to config the parameter. You can apply your idea to this class project. That I told you, I explained you 5 main screen. Maybe some group have an idea to design more screen. You can apply your idea to design more 5 screen. maybe you need to screen screen number 6 and you have some idea why we need screen another screen. You can present. You can present and you can show by demo when you submit. If each group, I think when you develop the screen or develop the code, I think not every group will design same screen. I think if any group develop by using copy code from another group, and I check the code they copy from maybe the group number 1, copy from group number 2 like that, the maximum screen it will divided by number of the group that they copy the code. Maximum of the score for the class project 30 if we have two group copy the code, and we will bring 30 divided by number of the group. That means each group it will get 15 for the maximum. Like that. Try to develop the code by yourself, or you can develop the code by see the code from another group, but you should be developed by your style like that. Don't be copy, or should be put your idea on that one also. And I think if you develop by yourself, I make sure that you will get different result, different screen. Okay, like that. Any questions, sir? No? Okay, maybe we will stop the record and we will